Hoki Maiti, we welcome back to Q&A. It's almost a year since the Taliban took control of Afghanistan. Since then, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has been working to evacuate Afghans who helped New Zealand forces during the war. And for the most part, it's been a major success. At the start of this month, I joined a group of those who were evacuated from Afghanistan in an emotional reunion as they thanked the Kiwi volunteers who helped to save their lives. But as you'll see, it's not yet mission accomplished.
It was a quiet Sunday, lunchtime, and a group of Afghan New Zealanders gathered in central Auckland, waiting for their special guests. The kids' printouts were pretty clear, 6 words in English that they didn't know they needed this time last year. Thanks, Alan, for saving my life. When Afghanistan fell to the Taliban in August last year, New Zealand's government committed to help.
Now we are looking to deploy an asset in order to facilitate the removal of both New Zealanders, but those that we consider may be at risk because of their association with New Zealand.
It opened up a special visa for those people who'd helped the New Zealand Defence Force in Afghanistan, and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs coordinated their evacuations. For former Army officers Chris Parsons and Alan Nelson, it was a deeply personal crisis. Having both served in Afghanistan, Alan and Chris worked around the clock coordinating lists of names and paperwork to help save the lives of those people who'd once protected theirs. This is the result. More than 1,700 people on various visas have been evacuated from Afghanistan to Aotearoa since the Taliban seized power last year.
So I think the government has done overall a great job. You know, we made this, or the country made this promise to bring these people to New Zealand, and for the most part they've achieved that. But there are a small portion of people that I don't think the government has fully met their obligation yet.
And this was the underlying vein of sadness at an otherwise joyous reunion. For all the people who have been saved by Alan and Chris and the New Zealand government, there is still a handful of people who haven't been able to come. Some have had their visas declined for reasons that aren't clear, but some never even had a chance to apply. Despite working alongside the New Zealand forces, the government gave them a tiny window within which to apply for a visa to get out. In the chaos and violence of the Taliban takeover, some of those who worked alongside our defence force never even knew about the visa until applications were closed.
There was only a 9-day window for people to apply for this visa, which is, you know, pretty tight when you're in the process of, you know, hiding and running away from the Taliban. And so the government set that deadline, all well and good, but people missed it and they have been unwilling to reconsider allowing an extension on that deadline.
Why isn't clear. The previous Minister of Immigration wouldn't be interviewed by TVNZ Sunday when they questioned him about the deadline earlier this year. But those who did get out estimate just 10 families, 60 or 70 people, are left.
To be honest, especially the Romero-based security guards, they were up on the mountains when the window were open, and they should be included because they were fearing for their life and they had escaped to the mountain from a Taliban prosecution.
Parwiz Hakimi was a translator for New Zealand's forces. He implored me to talk about Mohammed Murad, a former guard at a New Zealand operating base who'd missed out on the visa deadline. Shortly after applications closed, Muhammad's friends believe he was caught by the Taliban and shot dead. His wife and family remain stuck in Afghanistan.
If the government don't bring those guys who are eligible, that means the Prime Minister hasn't fulfilled her promise.
It's almost a year since the Taliban seized Afghanistan. In 2 weeks, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs will close its evacuation operation for good. But while Kabul starves under the oppressive Taliban rule, in Auckland, they're shedding happy tears. They've made it, they say, 95% of the way. They just need to finish the job.
Please do reconsider these visas that have been declined. Please do reconsider this arbitrary cut-off date. It doesn't make sense, and it's not in line with what the government promised, which was to bring eligible people here to New Zealand.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
How do you feel when you watch that?
Look, I think New Zealand overall has done an amazing job of bringing 1,700 people from Afghanistan back during a really difficult time. And when we set the criteria, it was during the period of an emergency evacuation when the US had signalled that they had a finite point to get out. And we were very mindful that the security issues on the ground and actually the logistics on the ground were at its most precarious and complex. When I think about the amount of coordination that's gone into ensuring that we were able to stand up across government agencies here in New Zealand, at least 100 people, if not a little bit more, during the heightened period of coordination to bring people back, it was a lot of work. And then we announced on the 29th of April this year that we will address the remaining eligible applicants on a case-by-case basis. Mm. We recognise we've still got work to do. My understanding is that we've got about 45 people that by the end of July and some weeks after, we'll still be facilitating the ability to bring them back. And then so far, we have had 19 people, for a range of reasons, reflect back to us that they are not seeking to come back or come to New Zealand. And there are a number of reasons for that.
So what about these people who would have qualified under that emergency visa because of their association with New Zealand, but were unable to apply for that visa and have been unable to apply for that visa ever since?
Look, the detail of the application process and their eligibility is a matter that I would fairly and squarely put with the Minister of Immigration in terms of the processing elements of it. But in terms of the way in which we've set ourselves up to respond, since the 29th of April this year, we are dealing with the remaining number of applicants that are eligible on a case-by-case basis.
Yeah, but the problem with these people specifically, and I know that the Minister of Immigration plays a role here, but the truth of the matter is that MFAT was the leading agency when it comes to the evacuation in the first place, and the cross-checking and compiling of the lists of people who did indeed work with the New Zealand Forces. Would you, in your capacity, advocate for opening the eligibility of that visa, even if only for a day, so that people who might be considered eligible will have an opportunity to apply?
Look, I'm not mandated to be able to do that. When we took the decision to set up a set of criteria for a finite period of time, that was a cabinet decision. And so we have stuck to that cabinet decision in terms of the way in which we've processed those who are eligible and have applied to come to New Zealand.
Would you support that if it came before cabinet?
Look, I'm not prepared to make a decision in the absence of a conversation at cabinet level, because the criteria was set by cabinet. Mm.
Is it kind to leave these people behind?
Look, it's been a challenge, and I recognise that. And this is a highly emotive issue for those who will feel that they were not included within the limitations of the criteria that was set for a very specific purpose, an emergency evacuation with a finite period, because the logistics of getting people out were pretty difficult. We have enabled 1,700 visa applicants to be able to come to New Zealand.
This is the thing, we're so close. It's like a few dozen more.
We are, and it will always be a few more. I understand that. In terms of the refugee quota that will be applied to Afghan citizens, that will take place in 23-24, we have that avenue. And that is another avenue to be able to address some of the issues that have been raised in that particular piece.